I think the MacArthurs were surprised that the Equality Commission had adopted this particular case. They couldn't do what the Equality Commission was asking, which was to admit they were wrong and apologise, because that would have been, as far as they were concerned, dishonest. They would be apologising when they didn't think they'd done anything wrong to Mr. Lee.
And how do you feel about that? Because you're raising money from your supporters to pay for the defence, and Mr. Lee has public money to pay for his application to the court.
Well, I just think a lot of people think, why should a statutory body funded by the taxpayer get involved in an issue which involves, as many people see it, obliging the MacArthur family and Ashes Bakery to help promote a particular cause? I think that many people would feel that if I go into one shop for a cake and I can't get it there and I have to go into another shop up the road to get the cake, as irritating as I might find that, and as upsetting as I might find it that somebody doesn't agree with the cause, I haven't lost a great deal. Whereas for the MacArthurs, if this ruling is upheld, it has much bigger impact on them than it would ever have on Mr. Lee or anybody coming in to order a cake. So initially, there was very much a sense of a kind of a David and Goliath about it, a sort of a £6 million a year publicly funded body with all of its many staff and lawyers pointing all of its armoury at a little Christian bakery. Maybe you're a vegetarian. That's very important to you. You run a business, printing or promotions. If you are asked to help do printing or promotions for a butcher, well, you're going to likely say no, because that's going to be hard for you as a matter of conscience to do that. And why shouldn't you be able to say no?
And yet the district judge thought that the MacArthurs were discriminating against Mr. Lee on the grounds of his sexuality.
That's one of the reasons why we think that the judgment is mistaken. The MacArthurs' evidence in court was crystal clear. They didn't know the sexual orientation of the plaintiff, and nor would it have mattered. I mean, Daniel MacArthur says, you know, if my granny came in and ordered this cake, she would have got the same answer. And nobody would have accused him of discriminating against his granny. It was just to do with the message on the cake.
I think it's really important to remember that the cake request was refused, not because Gareth Lee, the customer, was gay, but because of the message he asked for. That's a really crucial distinction for me.
The court inferred that they must have known because of the message that he wanted on the cake.
That doesn't make sense. I'm not gay, but I do support same-sex marriage. Something really vital is at stake, the freedom to act in accordance with your own beliefs. If this original verdict stands, a company will be under obligation, any company, to facilitate the dissemination of beliefs that they reject. So, you know, bakeries, printers, they will become the new front line of culture wars. Classic example, Muslim printer being forced to print pictures of Muhammad. That is the potential outcome
of
this verdict.
And this case has been tested.
If this case stands.
This is a hypothetical situation.
But it could very easily happen as a result of this verdict.
The law is not based on hypothesis.
This sets a precedent. It has been a divisive case. I wish it had never happened. I think it was wrong of the Equality Commission to take the case. There are far more serious issues of discriminations against gay people than we're seeing here. But I do think the verdict will be overturned, and I think that will be a victory for anyone who believes in freedom of speech and freedom of expression.